Here's another problem. There are also 5 bathrooms in another bath. This bath contains X blue bathrooms. X blue bathrooms. 2 bathrooms are taken at random without replacement. Now, we know that the simple probability of any event is given by success over number of items. Therefore, my simple probability for picking a blue button would be X, what are the success chances for picking blue, over the total number of buttons in this bar. But if I pick the second button, it is obviously that the number of blue buttons will be reduced by one button. Hence, in my second picking, I will have less by one button, and because I picked the first button, the total number of buttons has now reduced by one also. Therefore, picking the first button and picking the second button could be the probability for picking 2 new buttons. Now let's continue. If the probability is already given that picking both blue is this. This exactly tells us that picking the first button and picking the second button, if you simplify this probability, it will be exactly the same as the one given. Now, how do you simplify this? We multiply the numerators and also we multiply the denominators. When we multiply the numerators, we shall come up with x squared minus x over 25 times 24, that is 600. This should be exactly the same as 7/100. The next one we shall of course multiply. We shall be having x squared minus x. Now the value of 100 that side, we can leave it on this side so that we can simplify faster. The zeros will die. Hence we shall have x squared minus x is equal to 7 times 6, that is 42. We can cross over 42 and get x squared minus x minus 42 is equal to 0. By reaching there, we have now shown. Now, when we go to part B, of course now this is algebra direct. We are supposed to factorize. Right? So there are many methods on which we can use to factorize. We can use the sum product factor method. Sum product factors. We can find the sum, that is negative 1. The sum is the value ax squared plus bx plus c. The sum is the value of b. The product is the value of a times c. And in our situation, our a is 1, our c is negative 42, giving us negative 42. Now, we need to find two numbers. When you multiply them, they give you negative 42. And when you add them, they give you negative 1. So, those will be negative 7 and 6. We shall take the two factors and we replace them. X squared minus 7x plus 6x minus 42. We split the middle and factorize separately by taking the common term out. X minus 7, we take 6 out, x minus 7. The values outside, they will form one bracket. The values inside, they will form another bracket. Giving us two factors, that is x plus 6, x minus 7. In the next part, we are supposed to solve. When you look clearly, this expression here is exactly the same as the previous. This means we can just take the answer we got, we replace the two factors here. And it says equal to 0. Now, to One of the two numbers being multiplied should be always zero. Therefore, either this first number should be zero, or this second number should be zero. So when you take 6 the other side, shall be negative 6, and when you take 7 the other side, you shall get 7. Hence, the two solutions would be negative 6 and 7. However, since x is representing the number of buttons, and we cannot have negative buttons, we shall take our buttons to be 7. We go to the next part. Write down the number of buttons in the bag which are not blue. Now, since we said x is representing 7 and 7 is representing blue, and we know the total buttons there are 25, therefore, those which are not blue will be 25 minus the 7 which are blue, giving us 18 buttons. That is the solution to our problem. If you enjoyed the discussion, you can like and subscribe to my channel. My name is Ishen Roma Kionili.